All right, guys. Whoa. Is that really loud? Am I too loud? Okay. You're deaf like me. I need it really loud and I need glasses and everything. All right, guys. I'm so happy you're here. Okay. This is a special occasion because we're live tonight. We are live. Everybody cheer. Because this is a big deal for us, okay? We're so excited. So hello to all of you painting with us tonight. So I'm Miss Sarah. I'm going to be teaching you all this awesome Christmas bug. I mean, I think it's cute. You guys think it's cute? Okay, you guys have a couple colors on your plate, right? So you can switch up your bug, okay? If you don't want to do a red bug, you can do whatever you want. I know Paige will. She always does. All right, so have fun tonight. Get super creative. Or you can just follow me. I mean, whatever you prefer. Can you guys see my hand okay? Everybody see it okay? All right. That means you're in a good seat, right? Everybody's comfortable? Okay, you guys should have paint, plate of paint, two jars, right? You guys all have two jars of water? Okay, and then you also have three brushes, I hope. Yeah? Okay. Let's talk brushes for a minute. So you guys have a large flat brush. It's red. Everybody have that one? Okay. Then you have a medium flat. It's either red or it's white like mine. Okay. They're both the same. They're just different colors. And then you have a detail brush. Okay. It looks like this. It's very skinny, right? This is for small line work. All right. We'll use that for details later. So we're going to put that down. Okay, but we're going to start with our big flat red brush. And the reason you have two jars, I'll tell you now so you can be prepared, right? Okay, one jar is for rinsing. It's going to get really dirty. Your other jar is to double check. Okay, so if we move from a dark color to a lighter color, you'll want to double check your brush. Make sure it's clean. Isn't that awesome? So keep that one jar clean, okay? All right, have you met my helpers? Got helpers on the floor. I have Miss Brooklyn. She's in pink. Hi, Miss Brooklyn. Okay, and then we have Miss Maylee. Miss Maylee is behind the counter. Hi, Maylee. And then my son, Drew. He's our tech guy tonight. Hi, Drew. Okay, so Maylee and Brooklyn will be walking around the floor. If you guys need paint, or maybe you have a little smudge you don't love, or something is bugging you, don't be afraid to ask for help. Don't be shy. Because they are, okay, thank you, tech guy. Further away. All right, they're here, though. They are amazing artists, and they'll be here to help you, okay? So just let them know. All right, enough talking. Let's get painting. You guys ready? All right, let's take our large flat brush. Put in some water. We've got to loosen up the bristles. And let's make some jingle bells, because 'tis the season. We're just going to tap off the water, okay? So we have a damp brush. Acrylic paint needs water. It gets super thirsty. And I'm going to start by doing my background first, okay? So we're going to do the background around our bug first. It's a really light pink color. So to make pink, we're going to take a little bit, just a touch of red here, okay? Just a touch. And we're going to mix it with a pile of white, okay? You're going to need quite a bit to paint your background, so don't be afraid to get a large amount of white. You notice we separate our white here. That way we don't contaminate it all at once. Okay, so we'll have three different piles, but you can see I'm making a really light white or pink, not white. White's already light. So we're gonna make a really light pink. And if you want it darker, just add a little more red to it, okay? All right, and we're just going to start at the top here and work our way down. Carefully going around our image, right? Best we can, because we want to be able to see it for later. So I'm just brushing up and down around my image. And while you're at it, you can reach around and paint the sides of your canvas. We call this wrapping, like a crisp. See the sides of my canvas? Okay, the top is painted, The sides, the bottom, not so much, right? Because the bottom part is red, like the bug, okay? Yep. So we're going to wrap all the way around to finish it off. So while you're painting, go ahead and reach around and paint the sides and the bottom. That way you don't need to frame it or anything. It looks so pretty, just the way it is. Okay, so we're gonna keep going around here. You notice I get close to my bug, but I'm not painting all the way up against it, and I'll show you why here. I like to add a little bit of a glow, and this is optional. This is just if you want to. But if you take your brush here full of pink and you put a little bit of white on the corner as you're going, and then face that white towards your bug, go around it, you'll see that it just brightens up the edges. There we go. Okay. So if you want that, it kind of takes a little bit of the pressure off to have it perfectly lined up. And it gives it a little bit of a glow. So I'm going to go all the way around. So as you get close to your greenery here, use the toe of your brush to get into those tiny little places. The toe is this pointy part, the pointy part of your brush, okay? So you can turn it sideways and paint down into those little creases. There we go. Get all the way up against it. How we doing? Feeling good? And make sure you add a little water to your paint if you feel like it's kind of thick. Because acrylic paint needs that water. You can give it some white streaks with that white on the corner of your brush. Just go around your bug and lighten it up. And come up here and go around our gifts. Now this is a bow, right? So we're just gonna try and go around it. Fill it in later. If you accidentally paint inside your tracing there, it's okay, your image. No big deal. We're going to paint over it later. Okay. Looking good, guys. Hello. You made it. So glad you made it. Okay. Paint all the way around this ribbon. All right. Don't be afraid to have some little brush strokes in there. Adds texture. And this background's not the star of the show, right? The bug is. This is just gonna be in the background. That's why it's called the background. So don't stress it too much. We're just getting it on there. Yeah? Who said what? Huh? What? Oh, of course. Do what you gotta do, right? You can even go on the end if you need to. Oh, you're all sitting with him. Gotcha. Yeah, you're good. Okay. How's it going? Okay, we have one very important rule here, ladies. We have fun. Okay? Shake out the stress. You're going to love it 60% and move on, all right? 60%, because let me tell you, about halfway through, you're all going to hate it, and that's normal, okay? If you don't already. But with acrylics, we build and build, so you'll be really proud of it at the end. Be nice to yourself. 60%, move on. There's a lot of shades of pink. I love it. We got all shades. Oh, we got two-tone happening. So cute. I'm going to rinse my brush. You keep working on it. Oh no, what are they saying? Do I want to know what they're saying? Do we have questions? What? Sweet, glad it's working. How's it going, you good? Okay. Deep breaths, this is just the start. This is our warm-up, guys. That's a pretty pink, though. I love it. Such a pretty pink. Okay. Oh, are we getting fancy? We're just getting fancy. This is your anger issues on campus? That's awesome. I love it.
That was my mom, by the way. She's online.
This is you making comments?
No, this is my mom.
Well, no. Good job.
How did you get these trees done?
Our patterns. We make them.
Do you use, like, carbon paper? Or like,
it's like a thick paper. So we paint it, and then we print it. And our little sister is a genius with a knife, and she makes patterns.
Oh, cool.
With a knife.
Oh, wow.
I know, she's fantastic.
Does somebody draw on every single one of
we do, have? Yeah.
Oh,
Miss Brooklyn right
the
here.
Pattern. So
the pattern.
It's got like holes.
Yes.
And
so she, uh-huh. I know. Our team's pretty awesome. No.
Wow.
I know. I wish there was a way to do it so it didn't smear, but that paper will smear sometimes. And when you're doing this many, yeah. But I do like graphite paper for small things. Looking good, girly. I love it. All right. These backgrounds look fantastic. I'm supposed to switch the petals here, and I don't know which is which. Wait, there we go. I'm learning. Okay. If you have finished your background, we can rinse our brush. Paige is ready. You have blue background? Are you the only one that did blue? We got another blue one. Okay. I'm switching it up. Okay, we're going to use the same brush. So as soon as you're done, rinse it out in our jar of water. Make sure it's nice and clean. Your water should be pink. Then we're going to paint our bug. So this is where you get to decide what color your bug's going to be. You're going to switch it up, or are you going to do it red with me? I know. You have a lot of colors to choose from. Okay, and I'll tell you, if you want a turquoise bug, you have green right here. It's called phthalo green. If you add white to that green, you get turquoise. Okay? And then you have dark blue. If you add white to it, you get light blue, obviously, right? So you guys can switch it up. You can have a yellow bug. All of our lights that we have up here will look great with any of them. So we have, you know, all the different ones. So you guys decide what you prefer. But we have all these different bulbs. You can change your bug to go with any of them. All right, so let's add a little bit of white to our big brush here. Because we need a little bit of white in our red, believe it or not. Okay, anytime we use this acrylic paint, you want to add a touch of white to it. It just goes on better. It's shinier. It doesn't streak as much. Okay, so I just add a little bit at a time. Because I don't necessarily want a pink bug. I want it red, so just a little bit. As soon as you like the color, we're just going to start painting our bug in. And I'm going to move my brush in a rainbow direction here just to make that trunk look round. Okay, so I try to curve my brush with the trunk as I go. Now, if you try and go all the way around your bug without picking up your brush, you'll get that smooth edge. I mean, it's kind of tricky. So just give it your best shot. Remember, 60%, move on. Promise you'll love it at the end. I'm gonna brush all the way around our window here. Try not to paint inside of it if we can help it, but I already did, that's normal. We're gonna paint right over it later. I like to go around my greenery. It's shaped like a triangle shape. So if you move your brush first to fill in all the little triangle shapes there, and then go back and paint around your window, it's kind of helpful. There we go. It's just the first layer. Oh no, what? What? I don't like hearing, oh no. What's happening? Okay. I see lots of bugs, a lot of different colors. I love it. Now you can wrap your canvas so you can go all the way around it here. If you're worried about losing the tracing on your bug, I'll show you on this side. I can see my trace through my paint. If you're worried about losing it though, you can go right up against it like this and leave a little bit of white showing so you can see it. It's a preference thing. It depends on your paint too. Yellow, you won't need to do that. You can see right through that yellow. But a lot of times I'll do that. I'll come up close to it, but I won't paint all the way over the line if I don't want to lose it. Okay, gonna reach down and paint the bottom. Go around our headlights, because my headlights are yellow. Yellow shows everything, so I'm gonna try not to paint inside those headlights if I can help it. Paint around our square. Our license plate here is black, so don't stress it if you paint inside that square too much. Then I'm going to use the toe of my brush again to go right in between the square license plate and our little hatch on our trunk. I think it's a hatch. That's what I'm going to call it. Close enough. Okay. There we go. How we doing, guys? I don't hear too many sighs, so must be doing okay. Oh yeah, these are so cute. Oh yeah. So cute. Oh, we got some turquoise bugs coming in. Super cute. Now, because I have red on my brush, when I'm done with my bug, I'm going to paint my first gift here because I already have the red on my brush. Okay? Now, if you're not doing this gift the same color as your bug, you can rinse your brush out and pick a different color. I'm going to go ahead and just paint it, though, while I have that red. I have one gift that's red and one blue. We love to see what you guys come up with, though. Okay. I'm going to try and go around my ribbon because my ribbon's yellow. And again, yellow is a little tricky. Okay. Our little triangles here. You get to add your own greenery. So I'm just going to bring it down a little bit and let it be. Okay. Trying not to pick up my brush along those edges. Hello. Yep. I'm going to come right across the top of this. You don't have your greenery showing, but there's a little bit of your gift showing there. I'm going to come right across there. Just a little bit of a line. Switching up the colors. That's all the red work I'm gonna do, so I'm gonna rinse my brush for now. So when you're ready with that gift, you can rinse your brush out. You're okay, you keep going. This is gonna warm you up, right? You warmed up? I like your gift there. You're floating. Is awesome. I love it. Yeah, I'm seeing it. Okay, we're gonna do the stripes on our next gift. As soon as you guys paint in that one, we'll do the stripes on our next one. Don't worry, don't panic. I'm not moving on yet. You're doing great. You fill it in. Do you have a question, hon? Miss Brooklyn's on her way. Look at her. She's so fast. You want the finished painting? You want a view? Oh, yeah, I know. You guys are in the spot, right? Where the... Oh, that's smart. That's what I would do. I'd have it on my phone for sure. You're welcome to come take a picture of it, too, with your phone, if you want to. Yeah. Okay. We're going to switch brushes for those little stripes, okay? We're going to use our small flat brush. So as soon as you're ready, grab your smaller one, and I'm going to do my stripes blue. But if you want to switch that up, go for it. I already see a lot of different colors. I love it. First things first, though, always put it in water. Okay, and loosen up the bristles. Okay. So I'm going to add just a little bit of white and blue together to make a lighter blue. And I like to just add a little bit at a time so I can decide how dark I want to go. I'm just going to add a little bit until I like it. I think that's about right. But you guys can do any color you want. We're just going to put these stripes on here. Okay? I'm going to start right up here in this corner. You already have the trace on there. So you just brush straight up. We're going to put white on later, so don't worry too much about. If you paint a little bit inside the white line, it's okay. Our white works a lot like whiteout. It covers up acrylic paint so well. So don't worry too much, all my perfectionists in the room. And we'll add more to these two in a minute. We have one more. It's kind of hidden here. Easy to miss. It's right on the corner. So use the toe of your brush to get it if you need to. There we go. We are going to attempt to line up our lines, but you know. It's a painting, not a print. We'll embrace the imperfections, right? It's okay. Deep breaths. Lines are kind of intimidating. They just are. There we go. There's one more up here in the corner. If you want to use your detail brush to do it in a minute, you can. All right. What happened? We okay? We okay? Sounded like a moment of panic. Yeah, so if you want to use a detail brush, this little corner right here, you can. It's so small. Attempting to do it with that flat brush is a little tricky. So switch to that detail if you need to for a sec and just do that little corner. Straighten it out. We don't want to paint big things with our detail brush because it gives it really bad hairdo that's hard to fix. So just use it a little bit on those. How we doing? I'm going off of you up here. You're doing awesome. Be nice to yourself. Okay. I'm really not looking at you, don't worry. I won't make you uncomfortable. Ooh, we have most stripes in. Nice. Awesome. We're gonna do our greenery next, and you guys get to mix your paint and make your own green. What are you asking? The brush. I switched to my small one for the stripes. The small. Well, no, that one. Yep, that's the same width as your stripes. It should be. Yeah. If you need to use your detail, though, go for it with that, if that's a little tricky for you. All right. You guys ready to make some green? Greenery. It's okay. You guys just keep rolling. You're fine. You're fine. Okay. So you get to make your own green, which is kind of fun. This is a great opportunity for you to get creative on your color, right? We're all going to have a different shade of green. They won't all be the same. Now I'm going to use my small flat for my green. And I'm going to mix a touch. You'll see you have two piles of yellow, right? Does everybody have two piles of yellow? If not, separate it, okay? Give yourself two piles because you'll want to save some yellow for later. So separate it, okay? And then you're going to add a touch of green at a time to your yellow because look how fast that changes your yellow, okay? It is a really strong color. So just a little bit at a time. That way you can judge how dark you want it to be, okay? I'm also gonna add a touch of white to it. I'm gonna put some white in there and that changes it too. So keep mixing until you love the color. Now if you want more of a foresty green, you can add some brown to it. So you have some brown on your plate, you can just pick up a little brown, mix it in there too. Yeah, it just depends. A little brown will make it a little more foresty. More yellow makes it limey. Yeah. I like a lot of yellow in mine. It's just really pretty. Okay, I'm happy with my color. As soon as you love your green, and go ahead and start painting in the greenery here around your bug. And this is just our first layer. We're just gonna put it in for now. We'll add more later. Don't worry about all those corners being perfect because you're going to outline them in a minute. Okay, so you can see I'm just brushing out and I'm not worrying about whether it's a perfect point. Because we're going to come back later. Some of you may even like that look better where you just brush out and it's not so clean. Has a little more texture. You might choose to leave it. I almost did. Okay. If you have a question, hit me up, okay? We're just filling it in right now. Yep, we'll add more stuff here in a minute. Okay, do you want me to tell you how to mix your green again? Do we need another little reminder? Yeah? Okay, so you're going to mix a lot of yellow with just a touch of green. Okay? Add a little bit of white. But add just a touch of green at a time because it changes really quick. And then don't worry too much about the edges here. We're just brushing out. You can add a little brown, yeah. It makes it a foresty green if you add some brown to it. So if you want a little bit of brown in there, it's kind of pretty. Lots of little triangles here. This one goes straight up. I am using the smaller brush. If you prefer the bigger one or the smaller one, that's totally up to you. Yeah, have some fun with this greenery, you guys, okay? Doesn't need to be perfect. It can be a little messy. Takes a minute to get all the little ends done. You can get different shades in your green too if you don't overmix it. I have more of a flat green on mine, but if you want different shades, don't overmix your paint. Nice. Yeah, looks so good. Beautiful. Yep, so you can put a little bit of yellow on the corner of your brush, or you can put white on that brush and brush in any highlights you want to, just like that. This is just optional. You can do more of the flat color and then add the lines later. If you want to brush in a little white, I just put some white on my brush and I'm just brushing it in, giving it a little texture. Just if you want to. Because we're going to come back through in a minute and do all the lines. I see a lot of you doing this. It's awesome what you're coming up with. Different colors. Okay, and then I'm just going to paint my green ribbon while I have green on my brush. You may be doing a different color. So that's up to you whether you paint your ribbon right now or not. Okay. Nice job. I'm not going to rinse my brush, but if you are switching your color for your ribbons, rinse it out. Decide what color you want to do. Mine is green. I'm going to use the same brush. And I'm actually just painting it the same color as my greenery. So I'm just going to fill it in. First, we'll fill in the shape, and then we'll put that ribbon in. Put this in first. Yep, choose your shade. Now I'm just going to fill in my ribbon for now. We'll separate it later. But first, we just gotta fill it in. The details come later. Now we've gotta add the ribbon. In just a minute. Whoa, my brush picked up some yellow. Doesn't look like much of a ribbon yet, but it will, I promise. You get to add the ribbon freehand. Aren't you excited? No? No. Where's your sense of adventure? It's not that hard, I promise. You can do it. You can do this. So I'm just going to take this flat brush here. Okay. I'm going to come right up the center of my ribbon. Right up the center. Now the fun thing with this is you can make this ribbon however you want. Okay. You don't have to follow me. But that's all I'm going to do for my ribbon. I just went straight up. You can do it. Come right up the center. Now my other one, I'm going to start right in the middle of my bow here, okay? And I'm going to curve my brush as if I'm making a rainbow shape. Like that. Right? Making a rainbow. Now it comes out into a V shape, but I'm not going to do that yet. I'm just getting the shape first. Okay. Hello. How'd it go, guys? It's not too hard, right? We can do this. Okay, for that very, very end of my ribbon, I'm going to switch to my detail brush, and this is why. Okay? My ribbon here comes down to a V. Okay? So I'm going to use this detail brush so I can do that. I want to end it with a V shape. Okay? If you want to leave it straight, you can. You can end it like that with me. Yeah, very cute. You did awesome. They're adorable. Switch brushes if you need to, okay? That small flat is a little too tricky. Switch it over. And we're going to let that green dry for a second. Give it a minute. And we're going to come back to our bug. Now you can keep using your small flat. I'm just going to rinse it out really good. And we're going to make a gray for our window. Okay. I'll show you the picture here, what we're working with. You see my gray color here on my bug? Okay. If you want to change that, go for it. Make it your own. Okay. Get creative. Change your colors if you want to. I almost did it pink to go with my background. So, I mean, I went all over the place till I decided to land with gray. So have some fun with it. Change it up or follow me. But I'm just going to take my small flat here and a touch of black. Because if you're doing it gray with me, this black will change it really fast. It contaminates that paint super fast. So just use a touch. Okay. I've got a nice light gray. I like it. Going to go ahead and fill in my window. Now I'm moving side to side. That way those streaks give us a little bit of a reflection on our window, which I like. Okay, I need a little more paint. There we go. I'm gonna mix a little more. I'm gonna paint side to side. Now I'm going to try and go around my edge without picking up my brush, but again, that's hard. Slow down and just take your time getting that edge. Be nice to yourself. We are doing an outline in a minute, so it doesn't need to be perfect. I mean, if you outline with me. Okay. Oh man, edges are intimidating. Just do your best, right? You're doing great, buddy. You're okay. Yeah, it's great. Leave those streaks in there. Gives it character. And then we're going to paint our side windows. Or mirrors, not windows. That's a mirror. Little square. Same color as our window. Unless you did it differently. And again, you're going to outline it, so don't worry too much about that. And I'm going to paint that little latch on my trunk. And you can keep doing it with your small flat or switch to your detail brush to do that little latch, okay? It's a lot smaller. It's kind of tricky. There we go. Just curve it out like a rainbow shape. I'm leaving those streaks in there for fun. Wow, you guys are so focused. Should have heard our last class. I couldn't hear myself talk. I was literally yelling. It was 5-year-olds. Oh, man. Ooh, we were painting Frosty. We were singing Frosty the Snowman. The glitter? Is that what you're talking about? Yeah, it's glitter. No, well, it's glitter paint. Yeah. So it's like a white glitter paint. The kids love it. It's their favorite thing. They love it. It's super cute. All right. Look at you. Aren't you proud of yourself? What? Yes. So green is yellow, phthalo green, the dark green, touch of white. And then you can add brown if you want it like a foresty green. Okay. These look so good. Hope you guys are having fun. I am. Okay. I think we're about ready. All right. We're going to paint our yellow. So I'm just going to put a little bit of white in my yellow. Okay. And I'm using my small flat brush. Just gonna brighten up my yellow a little bit. Okay. We're gonna paint our ribbon here. Here we go. Let's paint straight down. And our yellow is super transparent. So if you need to cover anything up, put more white in it. And it will cover stuff up for you. This yellow shows everything. It just does. We're going to paint our ribbon. Now this ribbon's done for you. Kind of takes the stress out of it, huh? Okay. And I'm going to paint my tail lights while I have that yellow on my brush. Just put that oval in there with yellow. Okay. All right. So to get that little circle for all of our bulbs, we've got to finish our greenery so we can put our bulbs on there. Actually, no, I think we're going to do our bulbs first. Just kidding. Okay. So once you have those tail lights on, we're going to start our bulbs because we're going to paint them white first. That way your color really pops. Okay, for your bulbs. So we got to paint them white first, let it dry, and then put our color on. Okay, so let's go ahead and get some white on our small flat brush, or you can use a detail brush. Whatever is easiest for you to create a circle shape. Okay, now to give you an idea of where we're going to go with our bulbs, we have this little curve right here in our greenery. That's a bulb. Okay. So that's going to be my first one, just to help me with placement. So I'm going to give myself a circle there for a bulb. Okay. Now I have another one. It's right here on the corner of my red gift. So I'm going to create a little circle here. You see I'm spinning my brush, my flat brush, to get a circle. Okay. Then we have another bulb. It's just right here in our square of our red gift. Okay, now I'm going to come right back up here now. Right here next to this second stripe down, I have a little bulb. Okay, right there. You can put these anywhere you want. You can have some fun with it. Okay, I have another one right up here. It's between my curved ribbon and my little strand of ribbon coming up there. We're going to stack them. I'm going to put another one above it. Okay, I have another one that's coming right here next to my green bow. My last one comes right off my canvas here. Curve it a half circle. It goes right off the top. Okay. Just going to make sure they have a good layer of white. And then when you put your color on there in a minute, it'll be really bright. Awesome. I'll let that dry a second. And we get to start working on our detail work. Let's see where we're at. Got our bulbs on. Good job. Did you want to see where to put some white in your brush? And just cover it first and then put a layer of yellow after it dries. Yeah. Yeah, if you guys have any color in your ribbon and the yellow's not covering it, put a little white on your brush, paint over that, let it dry, and then put yellow back over it, okay? Your white will act like a whiteout. It really does. It just covers your color really well. Okay. So I'm going to use my detail brush now. We're going to just shape out our green ribbon. So if you change your ribbon color and it's not green, there I am. You're just going to want a darker shade of whatever your ribbon is, okay, to do your outlining. So I'm going to use my detail brush and put some dark green on it here. Okay. Now you can do it with green. You could even do it with black if you want to. I'm going to do green first to show you that option. The first thing we want to do is just come right down the center of our ribbon here. Okay, we're just going to outline it. You can see the green's pretty dark. It covers it pretty well. But if you want it darker, put some black in your green or do straight black. That's a preference. Okay. Then we'll come straight across the top of our box here. Here we go. Now we're going to separate our ribbon. We'll do the outside first, okay? Don't worry. We're going to do this little loop here. It's a rainbow shape. Now all of our ribbon's going to come off of that center rainbow, okay? And come right up here. So it comes right off that center. That's going to be your best friend here. It's going to be your guide as you do this. So I'm going to follow the outline first. Now once you do this to separate your ribbon, going to add a little bit of a rainbow here all the way to the side. See how it separates my ribbon? right there on the bottom. And I'll give it a little crease up the center. And there you go. You have one little ribbon done. Woohoo! Okay. I'm going to do it on the next one here. First, we're going to outline it all the way to that center. Remember, we're building off our center there. Okay. We'll follow it down. And we'll do the other side. Once you outline it, then you can finish it up. Okay. So again, we're going to add our rainbow shape on the side to separate it right there. And add your creases. Okay, so here we go. We're going to outline it first. Now this one's easy. There's no creases. Just bring it right down to the center. Here we go. Okay, let's outline this one next. Our last one. First outline it. Outline it first. Then add your curve, your rainbow, from side to side. And then your crease. Okay, then we're just going to outline our last ribbon here. Whew, how'd it go? Good? We get it? Outline first. Add your rainbow. All right. You guys, now your next one will be, you'll be pros. Now I'm going to take this dark green while I have it on my brush, and I'm going to start painting the outline of my greenery. Okay, so when you're ready, after the ribbon, and if you need help, ask Miss Brooklyn. She can assist you on that. I'm just going to start outlining my greenery. If you want to, some of you already did beautiful work on your greenery. You might be done. Okay. But if you outline it first, then you can add all the other little details. I'm gonna go along pretty quick, just filling it in. Okay. All the way around. I'm just using my dark green. Just the dark green on my greenery. If you want to add black, or if you want to do it black, you can. It's up to you. But we're outlining first. I don't have a lot of rhyme or reason on where I put all this. It's just gonna decide as I go, guys. Just have fun with it. adding that separation. Paige, I can't wait to see what you do here, girl. Because I know you got something planned. Okay, so now I'm going to start separating it here. You can just kind of separate the greenery by giving yourself mountain shapes. Kind of looks like you're just making those mountain peaks. See that? Just kind of let them fade out. Yeah. And they're all a little different. You can highlight it later. You can float it. I'll show you a couple things you can do. I'm just going to add a little bit of green around my bulb to give it a shadow while I'm at it. Just that dark green there. It's just dark green. Okay, you guys, you pretty much done all the hard stuff. Love it. I'm going to outline my yellow bow next. I'm doing it with black. Okay. Yeah, if you have anything to cover with that yellow, put white on it, okay? You can even put white on it first and then come back and paint it yellow when it dries. And it covers up everything. It's awesome. Okay, so one little tip on our black. If it's starting to thicken up on you, I want you to add a little water. Just kind of spin it in your paint. Thin it out. You don't want it clumpy, okay? Don't want it clumpy. Right? And we're going to do our yellow ribbon next. And I'm starting at the top because I don't want to smear my hand in it. Okay? So once again, we've got to do our center that we're going to build on. Got to do that first. Here we go. We're just going to come down. Now you can outline the whole thing. Or you can kind of just brush in some of it. And I don't do perfect lines because it's ribbon and it just kind of flows where it wants to go on your gift here. There we go. Just outline it first. There we go. Yeah, we have highlighting and some shading to do in a minute. We will do it in a minute. Okay, so first things first, we've got to outline our bow. So I'm going to come here and build off of that center, just like we did before. Go right off our canvas here. Okay, now once I have my bow, we'll do the same thing. We add our little rainbow shape here along the bottom to separate it. We'll finish our ribbon off. Always coming down to the center circle. Okay. This is probably the trickiest one right here. The side one, or it's the most intimidating, but it's not that bad, I promise. Okay, we're gonna outline it first. Now once it's outlined, we're gonna add a little bit of a curve right here. Right at the top, you're gonna make a teardrop shape to make it look like it's curved the other direction. So create your teardrop and then give it some creases there. Whew, how'd we do? That was the scariest part. You guys are golden now. I got some green in my bug. Got some green there. It's okay. It'll be a shadow. Now before you rinse your brush, we gotta do our bug. It's the part you guys have been waiting for. Or not really. Okay, let's go ahead and do the string. For our bulbs, we're gonna just connect them. Okay, I'm starting in the center. I'm just gonna add a string here, going all the way around, connecting our bulbs with the black. Okay. Curve it around, it's just wrapping around our greenery. We're gonna go all the way up. Just brush that black right in the center. And we're doing this before you paint it. So if you get some black in your white, it's okay. Yeah. Now if you wanna add a little bit of a dot here to connect each one, just do that right next to my bulb. Just a little one. That'll get you warmed up for your car. Okay, let those bulbs keep drying. We'll come back to it. We're gonna just outline our bug with black, okay? Start at the top so that you don't put your hand in it and smear it down. Okay? So we're going to start at the top. Outline our bug. I'm doing it with black. If you want to do a different color. Here we go. Follow the other side down. Now your trunk is just coming down at an angle on each side. We're going to outline our mirrors. Make them a square. Now the trunk, it has a rainbow shape. It's a little intimidating. Let's go straight across there. And yes, I'm going a lot faster than you. It's okay. I promise. I'm gonna walk around and guide you. You are just fine. We're gonna come right here though on each side of our window and just curve down. It's not traced for you, so you're just going to come right off that corner. Bring it around. Whoop, not that curved. Can't reach this side very well. There we go. Now I'm going to outline some of my rear view window. I'm not doing the whole thing. I know we have perfectionists in the house that will probably outline the whole thing. Go for it. I just let it fade out a little bit. Right. Paige, am I going faster than you? Dang it. Let me see it. Where are you at? She's so fast, you guys. Always faster than me. Okay. Now, before we put our black away, you just paint your square here for your license plate. I'm going to switch to my little flat to do it. I'm just going to paint a square. Just follow the lines. Black covers everything up. It's a wonderful thing. Okay. Fill that in. I forgot one thing. Did you notice? I didn't do the tail lights. Don't forget to outline your tail lights, okay? If you want to. I'm just going to go around them with my black. You should have done that while we were outlining our bug. I got ahead of myself. So I'm going to go around my taillights here with that black. There we go. Okay, we just got to do our highlighting and finish our bulbs. You guys did awesome. So the bulbs, if they are dry, all you're going to do is pick your favorite colors and put them over the white wherever you want. So you can do it like me, or you can change it up. Okay, I'm gonna do this one here yellow. This is gonna go right back over my white and put that yellow on there. I'm gonna do that one yellow and this one here yellow. Just rinse your brush between each one, right? Yeah, make sure you rinse your brush. Got a green one here. Rinse my brush. Then I have a red one. We try to do a circle, right? Circles are tricky. Got another red one. I'm going to do it up here. Well, that's a lopsided circle there. Try it again. Closer. All right, I'm gonna rinse. Got blue next. Okay, I'm gonna fill these in blue. Got some blue up here. Okay, and we have one more up top that I'm going to do blue. Yeah, you can switch it up. Do any colors you want on those bulbs. You don't have to do it like me. Wow, guys, you did awesome. We are finishing it up. We're going to do our highlighting. We are just about done. Now, if you want to, you can outline this gift here with some black. I'm going to come right here just along that edge. Just go straight down. Outline that square there. It's not a have to, but if you want to clean up any edges, just go right around it with some black. Here we go. Awesome. Okay, before I do highlights, I'm going to show you guys what I'm going to do for my yellow ribbon just to make it a little more gold. So I take my small flat brush here and I rinsed it really good. I'm going to put a little bit of brown on the corner, just like that. Okay. And all I'm going to do with this brown is brush it in along my yellow, just lightly dusting it. Do you see that brown just showing up on the sides? Okay. So if you want to add a little bit of brown, you can dust it in there. And it gives your yellow more of a gold look to it. I just kind of dust some brown in there. This is totally optional. If you love your yellow ribbon and you'd rather not do that, I put the brown wherever there might be a shadow. So where it's curved over right here in my ribbon, I'll put some brown in there. Dust some brown. You see how it changes my yellow just slightly. Just like that. But I keep my brown kind of in the shadows, just anywhere. Anywhere it might just have a little bit of a shadow. Dust it in there. Just like that. Just a little bit of brown adds some shading. All right, guys. All we have left is highlighting, and you guys have done it. And if you haven't yet, that's okay. Keep rolling. So the way we do the highlight on the green, rinse your brush really good. And we call this dry brushing. So I'm going to wipe my brush off on my apron, or you can wipe it on your napkin. Get that water out of it. You don't want it drippy. Okay? And I'm just going to put a little white on the very tip of it. Just like that. Just right on the tip, and then I'm wiping it off on my plate. I don't want it overloaded. I'm going to come right here to my green, and I'm going to just dust that white coming down my green. See that right there? I'm just going to dust it. That gives me the light that's highlighting my ribbon. I'm going to go right around the top of my ribbon. I haven't dipped my brush again. That's how light, okay? I'm keeping that white on my brush. Very light. Just dusting it anywhere I think the light might be touching it. Just like that. Just dust it very lightly. Whoop. That's an example of too much white. Dust that off. All right, we'll do the same on our yellow. Just gonna dust some white in the ribbon. Just lightly, lightly put that light in there. There it is. Looks so good, guys. Good work. Now I'm going to take what's left, and I'm just going to dust my window here with it to give it a reflection. What was that? I smeared my blue, apparently. Didn't even know it. Ladies, it's beautiful. I love it. I love them. They're so cute. I'm dying. Please tell me Brooklyn got a picture. Isn't she cute? Okay. Okay, I'm gonna use a detail, or you can float it with me with the flat brush. You can kind of decide which one you want to use for this, okay? I like floating best. So I'm gonna put some white here on the corner of my brush, just like that. And I'm gonna float some light along my bug here. And you can use that line brush if you want to. If it's easier for you. You all done, Paige? You ready to show it to me?
Sure.
Okay, we're just going to highlight. So use your detail brush, or you can float it with me. So to float the white, you just want to put it on the very corner of your brush, just like this. Okay. Follow it around. Or you can use that detail brush of yours to do it. Okay. Now I do one more thing with the highlighting. I just go around my bulbs. If you want to, just put a little bit of white on that corner of my brush again. Or you can use your detail brush and just go right around your bulbs, the top of them, and add a little bit of a rainbow shape for your highlight. Whoop, my blue is wet. There we go. Go all the way around our bulbs. Just to give it a little bit of light. And a little bit around our gift there. Whoop. Looks good, Kate. We're going to do some snowflakes if you want to. If you remember how to do your snowflakes, you just flip your brush around, use the back of it, dip it in your white, get a little chocolate chip. That's how you know you have enough paint. You just stamp a couple of snowflakes coming down. You can do a lot or just a couple. Love it, guys. Now, if you are done, you know what we do, right? We sign our name. But if you're still working on it, go ahead. I know I'm going to do it. Don't worry. I have being reminded to do Christmas, huh? I haven't forgotten, I promise. Some have already done it. They're so much faster than me. Whew. Yep, I'm going to outline this gift. I didn't see it here earlier. I skipped it. So if you want to outline that before you sign your name, and then make sure this license plate is totally dry before we do Christmas on it, right? Or whatever you want to put on that license plate. I'm going to sign my name. Rinse my brush now that I'm all done with my black. And I'm going to use white on my license plate. Now, the awesome thing with this is if you don't like it, you just paint right back over it with black. And you won't even know. So you can do it a couple times. Okay, I'm just going to do an X here. Dash. See if I can do it on my first try. M. We'll see if I can squeeze it in. Hey, not bad, not bad. And put some white highlights in my blue if you want to. All right, you guys. You did awesome. Thanks for painting with me. You all done, Paige? I'm waiting to see it. Okay, if you're still working on it, keep going. I'm going to walk around and help you with whatever you need. All right. But before you leave, make sure you grab your jackets, water bottles, anything else that you need. Guys, next time, I lost my mic. Next time. You ready to show me? We'll see it.
So cute.
You did purple?
Yeah.
I love it. I wanted to see what you came up with. Well, that's cute. Thanks. Do a little thing. I love your greenery.
Thanks.
That was a hard part. I was like, how am I going to teach the greenery? You did so good. It almost has like the Dr. Seuss look to it. Or is it Dr. Seuss? Yeah. Doesn't it? It kind of has the look to it. So cute.
Thanks.
How you doing, though? You doing okay?
Yeah, I'm good.
Yeah.
It's just been a hard couple weeks because it's like school and work. And it's like,
yeah.
I just wanted to be Christmas break already.
Where are you working?
I actually work at the Legacy Center.
Do you?
Yeah.
What do you do there?
I work at the front desk.
Do you?
Yeah.
Awesome. I'll have to go in and see you. No. I'm letting them finish. Should I? Should I do it? Okay. How do I do it? Okay. Hey, you're welcome. We'll see you later. All right. These look so good. Are you all done? Okay. Lots of different colors. Okay, I'm going to walk around and I'm going to help you, okay? Hit me up and I'll help you guys.